Presenter number three, Hannah Calkins. Hannah comes from us from the Department of Molecular Pharmacology and Cancer Therapeutics, and she's currently at Roswell Park for Comprehensive Cancer Center. Fun fact about Hannah, she actually hates all fruits that start with the letter P. Upon reading that, it really threw me for a loop. I started to think of what fruits begin with P, and I quizzed her. Pineapple, pears, all of which aren't on her list of things she eats. Her title for today's presentation is Combating Treatment Resistance in Lung Cancer. Hannah, if you're ready, set, pitch.
Lung cancer is one of the most commonly diagnosed cancers in the world and is the deadliest, which is why I'm working every day to find cures for these patients. Lung cancer can go undiagnosed for a long time, especially in people that are not smokers. This non-smoking patient population isn't typically screened for lung cancer, so therefore, when their cancers finally do get diagnosed, they are in late stages and these patients are in dire need of effective treatment options. So when a patient comes into the clinic with lung cancer, doctors can specifically identify what's causing their lung cancer by identifying mutations in the cancer cells. They can then give a targeted therapy to specifically kill these mutated cancer cells. So in my slide, this is analogous to identifying the color of the cancer cells and giving the same colored treatment. So for example, blue cancer cells get blue targeted therapy. Now, targeted therapy is effective for anywhere from 1 to 2 years in patients, but unfortunately, there are no curative options. Over time, all patients will relapse and their cancer will grow even in the presence of the targeted therapy. This is what we call treatment resistance. This treatment resistance occurs when the cells have now gained new mutations that allow them to grow in the presence of the therapy. So for example, in my slide, the cells have now taken on a red color. We know that these red resistant cells are different from the original blue responsive cells, but it's unclear why and it's unclear how to treat them. We can think of this in the same way that we think of the flu every year, how the strains of the flu are always mutating and always changing, which makes developing new vaccines more difficult. So in order to find new therapy options for these patients, we need to understand what's causing the treatment resistance in order to find new ways to kill these cancer cells. And this is where my thesis work begins. My thesis project is focused on understanding treatment resistance with the ultimate goal of providing new therapy options for patients. In my work, I have compared the red treatment-resistant cells with the blue treatment-responsive cells and found that a major difference between the two is the higher expression of a gene called BRD9 in the resistant cancer cells. We believe that the higher expression of this gene, BRD9, in the resistant cancer cells is what's causing their red color or causing them to grow and survive even in the presence of the targeted therapy. Through this discovery, we have been able to apply a specific BRD9 targeted therapy to these resistant cancer cells and have killed more than 60% of the cells. We are currently furthering this work by utilizing the BRD9 targeted therapy in mice. We are hoping to see that this is both safe and effective, furthering the rationale for use in patients. By understanding what contributes to treatment resistance and how these cells differ, we can give hope to lung cancer patients facing no other treatment options. My work into BRD9 targeted therapy shows both exciting and promising results and may just be the key to getting lung cancer into remission once again. Thank you.